Alison, you began playing the violin so young. When you look back at that period of your life, who encouraged you? What inspired you?
Oh, well, my parents. It was really came from my parents, and there were, you know, a lot of kids start violin or piano kind of around, you know, 5 years old, and a lot of times much younger, with like Suzuki style of teaching. And so my mother and dad, they had my brother start piano at 5, and then I started violin at 5. And we also did many other things like sports and arts classes and dance classes, and they were really looking for something that might stick for both of us. Wanted to make sure that we, you know, had a good introduction to all sorts of things.
Now, you're a 27-time Grammy Award winner. You've made history. How has that impacted your career in terms of just the visibility and the credibility?
You know, this, it's really amazing. I, you know, you feel like every record you make is the only one you've ever made and the only one you're ever gonna make. You know, it's you have such a concentrated amount of time on something, and you're not really thinking about what everybody's gonna think of it. You know, and kind of when it's done, you throw it out there and say, well, you know, we're satisfied with it.
That's why you find me here alone and still wondering why.
Hopefully someone else will enjoy it, you know, and to have things that we've done be recognized like that has been really incredible, incredibly unexpected, and I could have never said that I would ever be a part of that that whole thing going on out there. I really love, I love what I've got to do with the band. That has been really special. I feel like that's been, the stuff with those guys has been more me than anything else. When I mean me, where what I'll be remembered for is the work that I've done with them.
And you've been with them for 25 or 30 years.
Yeah.
How do you stay together so long?
You know, I think we've been lucky enough to all be so different that what everybody brings to the band is so different that it couldn't be the same if it wasn't the same five people. We've been lucky enough to have enough success where it's been valuable for everybody to come back, you know, even with the differences, or maybe somebody thinks, oh, I'd like a break from that. We've been lucky enough and blessed enough that people have been interested enough to hear us, you know, year after year. We've been very lucky.
I know so many aspirant musicians look up to you as a role model. You know, what do you say to them in this environment, in this music industry?
Boy, I always say that as long as you're singing what's true and true to how you feel and how you believe and stories that are true to you, that you relate to and feel like you have to say, if you have that connection to things, they really stay interesting for years and years. Those songs that touched you so deeply years and years ago, they still do. Lately, I've been listening to Zapp and Roger. And that I've been listening a lot to. I really like that song, Do Wah Diddy.
So that's one of Alison.
That's
Krauss's
one of my
favorites.
Yeah, I really like that. I like they're very. I like a nasty groove.
And any up and coming artists that for you are just exceptionally talented, the next Alison Krauss.
I don't know if I'd curse anybody like that, but. Boy, up-and-coming people. The gal, I tell you, I thought was so beautiful. I can hardly keep from crying when I hear her sing. She sang the duet part on that huge song, Somebody That I Used to Know. That gal, who is that gal? What's her name? You know what I'm talking about?
Do either of our wonderful, illustrious videographers know her name? What's
her name?
Do
you know what I'm
talking
about?
Kim?
Yeah, Kimbra.
Oh, my goodness.
Kimbra.
I hear her voice.
I heard it.
Oh, I can't even, when she starts singing on that song,